In this video lecture, we are going to derive the cost function for a Cobb-Douglas production function. Suppose we are interested in the minimization of this cost function, and the constraint is the Cobb-Douglas production function. So the a problem is objective function is minimizing total cost subject to a given level of output. So there are two approaches to be used. That is, we can use the Lagrangian multiplier method, or we can use the substitution method to derive the cost function for the Cobb-Douglas production function. So we are trying to use the substitution method. In substitution method, we choose the constraint and we solve it for either of the variable in term of the other variable, right? And then we substitute it in the cost function and we simplify it. So we are taking the Cobb-Douglas production function and we are solving it for x2, right? And if we solve it for x2, the value of x2 is given by this function. X2 is equal to y to the power 1 over b, a to the power minus 1 over b, x1, this is x1, x1 to the power minus a over b. Now we are putting it in the total cost function. So substituting the value of x2, where the value of x2 is given by this expression. So w1x1 plus w2, and this is the value of x2. Now what we are doing is we are applying the first order condition to obtain the conditional factor demand function. So if we take the derivative of this function with respect to x1, we get this equation, right? And putting it equal to 0, so we get we are solving it for x1, doing some basic algebra, and the value of x1 is ultimately given by this equation. This is what this conditional factor demand function, in which the demand for factor x1 is the function of w1, w2 and y. W1 and w2 are the input prices and y is output level, and it is given by this equation. In the same way, we can obtain the conditional factor demand function for x2 as well. So you can verify it yourself. Since you solved the production function, that is the Cobb-Douglas production function for x2, now you can solve that for x1, and then you simplify it, and then you substitute in the cost function, you simplify it, and ultimately you will get the conditional factor demand function for x2 is equal to this value. So we obtain the conditional factor demand function for x1 and x2. Now if we substitute the conditional factor demand function for x1 and for x2 in the cost function, we get the cost function for Cobb-Douglas production function. So we will get the cost function is, since it is equal to w1x1 plus w2x2, if we substitute the value of factor demand function for x1 and factor demand function for x2 and we simplify it, we will get this total cost function for the Cobb-Douglas production function.